This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Prius. Let's lead the way.
This is your brain. This is your brain on love. Yeah, I'm sure there are questions. Hey everybody, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. Love is a huge emotion. It pulls information from our senses of sight and smell, our experiences throughout our life, and hormones start flying through the body, affecting our attachments and our feelings and our reactions. And all this is driven by your brain. It controls everything you are. Scientists know this, so they wanted to scan people's brains who are experiencing love. Functional magnetic resonance imaging looks at how blood is flowing through your brain to determine blood oxygenation, and therefore what parts of the brain are working hardest. In 2005, the American Physiological Society looked at the brain of 17 men and women who were newly and madly in love. Looking at scans, they found activity in their brain's motivation, reward, and drive aspects far more than emotions or sex. They say that romantic love engages brain systems associated with motivation to acquire a reward, which is to say, a match for reproduction and genetic compatibility. That pairing elicits the emotions of euphoria and happiness that we then feel as love. But the question scientists kept asking is, how does love show up in your brain? When the APS researchers used those fMRIs on participants, they found that romantic love activated the right side of the brain and areas related to subcortical reward systems, while facial attractiveness activated mostly in the left side of the brain. But a new study in Frontiers of Neuroscience scanned way more than 17. They went all the way up to 100 men and women who felt a range of love-related emotions. This new research found that as love progresses, the activity changes the brain itself. People who are in love reflected those earlier studies. Activity showed up in reward, motivation, and emotion regulation, as well as social cognition. On the other hand, the longer that they were out of love, the lesser activity they had in each of those areas. Being in love seems to change how our brain works and organizes itself for everyday behavior, not just the love stuff. This is the first time brain structures have been shown to change for those in love and for those who have ended love, as they called it. Of course, this is just a cross-sectional study. Ideally, researchers would follow those participants to see how their brain changed over the years as they go in and out of love. Knowing the neurological activity behind love helps us comprehend how love serves to draw us to ideal mates for genetic and reproductive reasons. But in the end, we're gonna need a lot more information to know why such a complex hormonal and neurological dance is performed. This new research mirrors the way that other animals seem to experience love, which might seem to make it kind of cheaper. Outside of stories, movies, and music, what is love? We're still figuring that out. What do you think, though? Tell us down in the comments, make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thank you very much for watching.
This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Prius. Let's lead the way.